Let's take you out to the beach. Speaking of places that can give you joy, really nice out there. Look at that. Now, we saw a lot of sunshine today. That is going to change at the coast. Big changes in temperatures coming up. 102 in Paso Robles still, 96 in Atascadero, 75 in Slo, 85 Santa Ynez, 65 in Santa Barbara, 66 for us in Lompoc, 68 Pismo Beach, 69 San Simeon, 65 for us in Los Sosos. Do you see those winds? They are breezy, 15 to 25 miles per hour at the higher end. And of course, that's clearing out the skies. But it also translates through and below those passes and canyons in Santa Barbara County. It has been hot. It has been dry. It's been hot for an extended period in the interior. You can imagine the elevated fire threat in that area with winds up to 40 miles per hour through 3 a.m. So if we can get past that, I think we're going to start seeing some cooler temperatures, and that will help. Okay, Isaias is back to a hurricane. It is currently sitting just off to the east of Charleston, South Carolina. Wilmington, North Carolina is under the gun in one of those outer rain bands right now. So tropical storm warnings and hurricane warnings in place for that area. Watch this path for Isaias. It goes through the land portion of eastern North Carolina, past Raleigh toward Norfolk, Virginia, and then it's near the nation's capital as we get into Tuesday morning. Beyond that, it's up through Baltimore, New York City, Burlington, Vermont could see a tropical storm, Quebec could see tropical storm force winds, and up to 4 to 6 inches of rain on the high side, and then ultimately it just kind of meanders toward the Northwest Passage. Wow. Okay, for us, again, clouds are mixed out on the Central Coast, South Coast. We do have some clouds, and temperatures there were cooler as a result. They clear out those clouds tonight with those offshore sundowners, but I do think they fill back in by tomorrow morning. Then it's coastal clouds, but partly cloudy. I like the clearing pattern tomorrow. The clouds are back in on Wednesday. Look at Wednesday afternoon. The clouds clear out again. But why? Because the winds, the northwest winds, much stronger. As we get into Thursday, early clouds and even some coastal drizzle possible before the marine clouds back off. When you look at the infrared, nothing really big here. But in terms of analysis, if we look at the water vapor, you can see that upper level ridge moving off. There's a trough starting to slide into Northern California, and it's going to take 10 degrees off interior temperatures tomorrow and another 10 as we get into Wednesday. Easier to see on this chart here. You can see how that U-shape forms over the Central Coast in California, really nosedives the temps into this upcoming weekend pretty mild. Let's take a look at it. So 92 in Paso Robles. Again, it's over 100 right now, so that's a big cool down. 77 in San Luis. It was 90 in San Luis today. Santa Ynez Valley temperatures in the 80s. South Coast temperatures in the 70s. The Cuyama Valley into the 90s tomorrow. The beaches still the upper 60s. North Coast beaches in the lower 60s. And the trend in the extended is definitely down. Now, it's very subtle across Santa Barbara County, but check out Paso Robles. 92, 82, 81. And then that rebound for up toward the weekend into next week is subtle. And we do not return to blistering hot temperatures.